11 जुनाक जावपी पंचायतीच्या वेचणुकां खातीर अर्ज स्विकारपाक वेचणूक आयोगाचे निर्वाचन अधिकारी सज्ज जाल्यात. बेस्तारा सावन सगळ्या निर्वाचन अधिकाऱ्यांच्या कार्यालयांनी अर्ज स्विकारपाक सुरुवात जाल्या. 25 मे अर्ज स्विकारपाची निमणी तारीख आसतली. वेचणूक लढोवपाक इच्छूक आशिल्ल्या उमेदवारांनी आपले अर्ज सकाळचे 10 ते दनपारचे 1 वरां मेरेन निर्वाचन अधिकाऱ्याकडे सुपूर्द करू येता, अशी माहिती राज्य वेचणूक आयुक्त आर के श्रीवास्तव हांणी दिल्या. अर्डेक्स गोवा ब्युरो रिपोर्ट.
As everyone is aware, today the nomination process started in all the taluka headquarters. Our mamladars or joint mamladars are acting as returning officers. So the nomination forms from desirous candidates, anybody who is willing to contest the election will be accepted from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. in all the offices of the ROs till 25th of May. And Sunday, 21st of May, there will be no nomination, it being a Sunday holiday. Now there are 21 returning officers and 21 assistant returning officers, that makes 42. In addition to that, 12 general observers have been pressed into service right from I think 15th of May. They will be acting as the eyes and ears of the commission, and they have already visited all the RO's office yesterday. I have received the report from all the general observers, and they have confirmed that all the returning officers are in a position to accept the nomination, and the process which has to follow thereafter, they are fully geared. Preparations have already been made by them. Besides, they are also taking stock of the ballot boxes, whether the RO is prepared and whether he is ready, and whether training schedule for the election staff on the day of poll has been drafted or not. They are also trying to see the polling stations where waterproof pandals need to be erected. So really, we are already available in field, and the reports are being received on a regular basis. The model code of conduct which has been enforced from today, this will remain into force till 13th of June when the counting takes place. It will continue till the counting is over. If it spills over to next day, fine, it will continue till that time. Now, when the court comes into being, there are restrictions imposed on the panchayat bodies. I must clarify that this code will apply, and it has to be enforced, especially in panchayat areas which are going to polls. It excludes the municipal areas, it excludes CCP area where there is no panchayat election. It also excludes 5 panchayats which are not going to polls for the time being. Now, when the code is enforced, these panchayat bodies are debarred from taking any decision, any policy decision, which will not be possible for them to be taken in this period. Second thing, if there is any development work which is already going on, that work can continue where the sanction order has been issued, work order has been issued, work has started, can continue. But no new work, no new scheme can be started. So this is what we are strictly following. Same logic applies to the government also. The government also cannot announce a new scheme which will have the force of luring the voters or attracting the voters to cast vote in favor of one party or the other. Of course, it is not on party lines, but the government also cannot announce any such mega schemes.